Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk about deaden the room. I'm sure you've heard this phrase before. Well, we have to deaden the room, or we have to deaden this area of the room. If it's a live room, maybe we got to deaden this. Anyway, you get the idea. And this is where simplifying things that acoustically benefit us to the point of ludicrousness, really. The last thing we want to do is deaden anything. We don't want to kill anything. We don't want to do this or that to it. You know, we want to work with it in its form and get it to work for us to match our usage. And when you start using terms like that, I mean, people get it. It's, well, we're going to put absorption in. And that's about it. We're going to make it, you know, lower the reverb times by adding absorption to that area of the room, this or that or the other. So, you know, stop definitely applies to absorption, but it's usually kind of any kind of absorption. Ceiling tiles. Okay. There's a good situation where wrong rate and level of absorption. They don't do much. They get a very narrow frequency range. I get it. They're a half inch thick and they suspend in a drop ceiling. But there's really better ways with a drop ceiling to get, you know, a much higher rate and level of absorption. And sometimes in certain situations, the ceiling is all you need to treat. So you don't even have to mess with the four walls. So it's, you know, definitely viable. There's nothing deadening about it. You know, you have to develop a strategy. What are you trying to do? Take the usage, the dimensions, and you're going to have two issues, pressure and reflections. That's it. Absorption is a middle and high frequency issue, over-absorption. And over-absorption reduces the air and the space and the distance between the notes. You know, squeezes everything together. So you have to be very, very careful because reflections and reverb is the natural way we hear things. So that's why you got to develop a strategy. You got to know what the sound is that you want in the room and treat for that. We can. We have those technologies today. Not boxes filled with building insulation. That's not a technology. But what you have to do is, you know, figure out what you're going to do for a strategy. That's the goal. People say, well, deaden the room. Well, that usually means over-absorb in a lot of cases. You can't over-absorb. You can't put too much treatment in if you have the right rate and level of absorption that matches the usage of the room, the pressure levels in the room. What are you going to do in the room? Well, treat to the usage. That's all you have to do. It's more complicated than that, but that's the rough idea. Music and voice, here's another thing people don't understand. You got to treat them with care. You got to have a technology that has a rate and level of absorption that's linear, that matches, you know, the frequency range that is the most predominant. That's the one you want to go after. Anything above that, well, it's a benefit, but it's that 125 to 500 cycle range. You don't want any spatial irregularities. You don't want any peaks, any dips. You can't have it. It has to be smooth. I've tested this for years. You don't want to deaden. You want to attenuate in a linear way. You want to make it smooth. You want to take a little bit out each time as you move up the frequency range. That's the goal. That's the goal. Look at the foam graphic. Look at our performance here. Look at the other two. Why would you treat a problem with a tool like that? It's like Phillips screwdriver on a regular head. Doesn't work. Balance the reverb to match the usage. Don't deaden the room. Just do some balancing. That's going to be the objective once you have a strategy. Hope this helps. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video, and if you liked it, please give us a thumbs up. We also have a newsletter that you can subscribe to, so please do that because we offer special price discounts to only those on our newsletter. And then don't forget about our forum. We have started a forum on our own website where people ask questions and I usually get a chance every couple of days to look at it. There's an interchange between people on the forum and we'll give you real answers on a regular basis, so that'll help you. Thank you.